Hello, all greetings. This is Gilles Mancillon, and I come to you today to continue my brief discussion about angels and archangels. But first of all, I'd like to thank you for showing up, for listening to this message, for attuning to the frequency of that angelic frequency that we are seeking to explore and develop. For the angels are always with you, but and so you can always talk to them. They will always hear your thoughts, your questions, your prayer. But it may be difficult for them to respond directly unless you are in a position, if you're in a state of consciousness that is tuned enough to their own frequency. And so I invite you now to stand, to take a few breaths, few deep breaths for relaxation, and breathe in this angelic light. When you think of breathing in, every time you breathe in, this light is filled up with angelic light, and so it invades your body. It is we may stand now in this pink light, the pink light of love, of unconditional love, and so the more you breathe, the more you breathe in this light consciously, the more you will feel this energy. You will sense your heart opening and the love of the angel, the love of source, the love of all that is, that may be filtered through your heart. And so it is important throughout the rest of your day, and as long as you desire, you need to work with this energy. So be conscious, be aware that as you breathe in light, you release, when you breathe out, you release all the tension, all the everything that may still stand between you and being in a state of total peace, total joy, total harmony. And so it is very important to continue to call on the angels, to call on them, because they are your support team. They are part of your higher self. They are basically where you wish to be, where we wish to be. For our angels, our guardian angels, are holding the frequency of the consciousness that we need to attain within this lifetime. For angels are always living in collective frequency, collective consciousness. For they are never separated from anything or anyone that they are connected to, for they are part of us as well. So you may connect to your angel through your heart or through your crown chakra to allow the energy to come down. And so it is about learning to become more, to integrate more of that angelic energy within yourself, to look through the eyes of love, to be accepting of the divine presence in all aspects of your life. And so as we become more familiar to breathing in this higher light, we are able to integrate more of those higher dimensional frequency around us within our consciousness, and it becomes more solid as we keep on breathing, and we become more conscious as we continue to visualize this pink light that is expanding from heart to heart, from my heart to yours, from your heart to all of those people you think about or may wish to connect with. And so we through that we will become fully integrated collective self. And so it is very important to send pink love, unconditional love, pink light into all your source, all your relation. It is a wonderful light to nurture, to cultivate within yourself. For angels works in every frequency of light. I just chosen this pink light today to so that you may feel that light. It is very easy to feel. It is very easy to accept love. It is unconditional love. It does not have in any way, form of shape. There is no attachment to this love. It is pure. It is something you may call upon. As you call on the angels, you keep on breathing this light, and so it becomes more powerful within yourself, and so your whole frequency becomes elevated. And I just wanted to come back and do this little conversation about angelic light and frequency. Of course, I haven't really been able to go all around the subject. I haven't really fulfilled all that integration in terms of the angelic realms for the 9, 10, 11, 12 dimension of their submetrics are mostly dedicated to angelic work and angelic integration. I will share a little story to finish this video, this message. Is that sometime in 1992, I was living in South Beach in Florida, and I was having a very difficult time emotionally. And so I had a conference with a friend of mine who was a medium, who was a channel, who channeled my, my some of my guides. And my guardian angel came, and she we had a discussion. And at the end of the discussion, she told me that she would send a symbol of her, something that I could think of her, to help me think of her. Not that I need that, but she kind of said that to keep my eyes open, because she would send me a symbol that would represent her. And so this symbol, I've been always keeping it with me. It's a little symbol. It is a star, a seven star. As I was walking through a landfill, something just like a whole, it was a construction site I was walking through, and I find this little thing on the floor. It was so magic. It was so magnificent. And of course, here it's just presented as something that is completely able to change shape and form, but it is a seven star symbol, and I've always kept it close to me as I continue also to stay in touch with my guardian angel. She's not necessarily the most talkative of my guide, but I know I can count on her. I can call on her anytime, and I know your angels are with you. So if you instruct them, if you give them give them instructions, if you wish, and thank them for helping you with those projects, they will do all they can, and they are very much here to they're really much wanting to be part of your life, more part of your life on the conscious level. And so it is important to day after day to work with them, to integrate this light and keep on breathing this higher light, this higher love, and so you may eventually become a fully integrated human angel into this reality. I thank you very much. Feel free to subscribe, share, and if you have any question, feel free to ask. I will do my best to answer. I wish you a wonderful day. Namaste.